addressed all warnings and errors in the Microsoft Accessibility Checker. Go to the File menu, Inspect Presentation, then click Check Accessibility. This panel shows up on the right. Missing slide titles is the first issue we must address. You see, quite a few slides need attention. Slide 3 is an example. Compare that with slide 2. Slide 2 has an appropriate heading. The other issue is the reading order. Let's look at slide 4. Watch how the reading order is set up. Slide heading, photo illustration, reference, text content, primary graphic. How do we fix the reading order? Click Home tab. Find the drawing group. Click Arrange. Then select Panel. Close the Accessibility Checker panel. You see the new panel here on the right? Match the selection to the object on the slide. Reorder the objects. Select on the object, then click the up or down arrows on the panel to select the order. Continue this process until you are satisfied with the order and that it is in a logical sequence. Fixing the problem with no title. Slide layout templates have been tested to work with screen readers. Templates assist with readability and reading order for screen readers. Avoid drawing or creating ad hoc text or content areas into layouts. In the previous slideshow, we had seen some of these problems, and as a result, they showed up in the accessibility checker. I'm going to show you now in another slide series what they should look like. Here we have a slide that has questions to ask yourself as the header. So if I have this selected, there'll be a little red box around it. And if I go up to Home Ribbon, click on Home Ribbon, and then go to Layout, it's going to show me that it's one of the design templates in PowerPoint. And that's what you want to see for your slides. Now I've gone back to the first slideshow, and you see this title here is not going to be fixed correctly for a screen reader to find it as a heading. So what we would have to do is we'd have to come to this slide and go up to Home, click on Layout, and then set the slide to be title and content. Now you see the first thing that's going to happen is going to say click to add title. So in this case we would have to type in the same text that is up here. Now this changes the layout of this slide so much so that we'll have to move this out of the way and come down here and actually delete this. Now someone who has made this slideshow may not like the design, but as long as it has this content placeholder titled over here as Title 1, you know that it's going to be accessible. They can also come in here and then reformat this with fonts. They can change the heading to a different font, like Arial. They can change the color of it, like green, and so you have all those choices that you can do, but if you don't have a title, it's not going to pass the test in the accessibility checker. I want to reiterate that sometimes the headings look like they're there, but they're not. In this case, I go up here to slide 3 and you see it says engagement here, but there's no title. So the heading that we require is for this to be a title, and the only way to do that is to come over here again and go through Home, Layout, and then select Title and Content. It will give us a blank title, and what I would do, of course, is I would just call this engagement, and I would delete this out, move this down a bit, and then put engagement in here at the top. And you see the reading order is also something you're going to have to fix on slides. Let's move the title up. The combination of not having titles and not having a reading order set is why this slide series scored as it did using the accessibility checker.